Okay, entrance exam fee is exempt. Now these were to buy. Okay, it is provided by institution. Okay, now there are certain activities that we provide to education institution. Hello. So in this entry we are having two items: services provided by institution and services provided to institution, educational institution. Am I clear? Yeah. So look at the first point. What kind of service me or as a normal people we can provide to institution? First is transportation of student. I hope you have seen lot of buses on road with a school and college name. You typically yellow color buses. Yes or no? So that bus driver or owner of the bus is not running an education institution. His job is he has bought 5 buses, and those 5 buses he have given to one college, and that college gives him rent per month. Yes or no? Yes. Hello. Now the guy who owns these 5 buses is not providing education, but he's providing services to education institution, and that services provided to education institution is also exempt. Now the transportation can be provided not only to student, it even faculties can go along in that buses, and even staff can go. Yes or no? Hello. If one bus is there from Jogeshwari to Andheri, hello, and if I'm also staying in Jogeshwari and some students are also staying in this building, why should I go by auto rickshaw or some other mode of transportation? My school bus comes here, so I will also get along with my students. Yes or no? Hello. So it cannot be, it's not that only students are exempt. Student, faculty and staff, all three exempt. Now in school you must be knowing, some people goes to school only to eat food, because sometimes government provides a very good amount of food, milk, and you know, sometime on some days egg is also provided, midday meal is provided. Yes or no? All right. This happens usually in government school. Okay, what this is example. In private school anyhow it happens, but in private school you pay for it. In government school or government aided school it happens without paying for it. Hello. All right. So what is that? So usually a restaurant is taxable or not taxable? Do you pay tax on restaurant or not? Yes, 2.5 we pay in restaurant. Okay, if you are taking catering services for marriage and party hall and all, then you have to pay 18% tax. Yes. Hello. All right. So there are different tax rates. So there is a tax on food. Yes or no? But this catering, so I have one restaurant and I'm providing some meals to one school. Okay, my restaurant is taxable, but the food that I'm providing to one school is exempt. So catering including midday meal scheme sponsored by central government or state government or union territory is exempt. So I will just charge fees from them, I will not charge any GST on that. Okay. Yeah. Next, apart from transportation and food, what else I can provide to education institution? We can provide security. You know, every school and college will have some security guard. Usually security is taxable, I told you, and that too under reverse charge now. Hello, security services are in. I told you we will revisit reverse charge mechanism when we are going into exemptions. Okay, so security is taxable or not taxable? This security guard who are providing security to satellite park, taxable or not taxable? Taxable, and that too under reverse charge mechanism. Are you getting this? But security provided by security agencies to school is not taxable, it is exempt here. Apart from that, in school we are having housekeeping. Yes or no? People who are cleaning floors, people who are cleaning toilets. Hello. So the housekeeping services are also exempt. Okay, security and housekeeping. Lastly, services in relation to admission and conduct of examination of such institution. So ICAI, our institute, or your ICA, cost accounting institute, doesn't have examination halls. Yes or no? They don't have examination hall. So what they do in examination, they do tie up with some colleges. Yes or no? Now those colleges are allowing our institutions to conduct examination in their buildings. What do you think? Is it for free? No, they will charge some money. That means one building is charging, one school is charging fees from your CA institute. Yes or no? CACMA institute. Are you getting this? Sure? Yeah? They should not charge GST on it. Why? Because they have given this particular examination building, this building, for admission or to conduct of examination. Yes or no? So that is also exempt. Next. Now the world is changing very fast, and day before yesterday also we were discussing, now no more this physical books and notes are required. digital studies has to come into place. So our modules are and all, instead of printing, they just have to upload soft copy like this, and then we all will be having either laptop or a pad with us, okay? And in iPad we can read and write everything, okay? So this thing, this base should come, and therefore they are saying supply of online educational journals and periodicals should be exempt. Hello? Online journals and periodicals should be exempt. Now when I read all this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay, apart from these five activities, and these five also having some you know, some exceptions that we will read now, apart from these five, any other services provided to education institution is taxable. Yes. Only five are exempt. Like I'm a chartered accountant and I'm doing audit of one school. Hello? So services provided by chartered accountant to a school, taxable or exempt? Taxable. Are you getting this? As a cost accountant, you are providing consultancy services to one school. Taxable or exempt? Taxable. Okay. Your father owns one building, full building. Okay. And he wanted to give it to school either on a rent. So renting of immobile property to school, taxable or exempt? Taxable. Hello? Not for conducting examination. Whole school, you are giving it on a rent. You just had one building, you are giving that as a rent. Any other services provided to school is taxable. Therefore, what is exempt, you need to remember. See, what is taxable, I can't remember because we don't have list of what is taxable. Everything is taxable. Only these five activities are exempt. Yes or no? Now in this, okay. Now please understand, this is preschool. Okay, preschool. You understand preschool? School before school. Kindergarten or this, you know, the small children, they go there. Okay, small kids, they go there. Now, this is preschool. Then this is up to HSC. Up to HSC means up to plus two. Okay, some people call it plus two. In some state, it is known as plus two. In Kerala and all, they don't call first year junior college and second year junior college. There they call it as a plus one, plus two. In Karnataka, up to 12th is a school only. Hello? College starts after 12th. Okay? So this HSC, higher secondary certificate, no, school certificate, whatever it is. So plus two. And then here we are having higher education. We are having higher education. So these are the three divisions of education system according to this exemption notification. Alright? So I am reading the first paragraph, and you need to tell me what exactly that paragraph is saying. However means exception. However means? So we have read that five items are exempt. Services provided to institution, five items are exempt. Which five items should I revise one more time? Which five item? First is transportation of student. Second is conduct of examination. This is by, okay? Sorry, not by. Here. Services provided to transportation of student. Second one is catering. Third one is security and housekeeping. Fourth one is services related to admission and conduct of exam. And then online generals and periodicals. Again, first one is transportation, second one is catering, third one is security and cleaning and housekeeping, fourth one is admission and conduct of examination, and last one is online. Do you think I will provide online education to preschool or even to HSC student? Online education, they don't understand how to use online education. Yes or no? As a graduate student, you people are graduate student and postgraduate student, yes or no? Do you know where to eat, where to shit? You know this?
Yes.
But they don't know it. These preschool people, they don't know it. So they eat and shit anywhere. And sometimes they eat shit. They don't know how to operate it, no? Yeah? So, housekeeping is mandatory where? Mandatory. It's like housekeeping has to be there.
Preschool
and this level, in graduation and all, in CA institute, CM institute is not required because we people are grown up. We know where to do what. Yes or no?
Yes.
Alright, exceptions are there, you people are having. But usually I am saying, okay. So this is there. So you can see these kids are coming. No, they don't know how to behave. Alright. So for that we need this kind of services, housekeeping and cleaning services. Okay. So these exceptions are not for all institutions. Okay. These exceptions are for selected institutions out of it. So I'm reading the first paragraph. However, nothing contained in sub item 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3 means you understand? 1, 2, 3 means one is what? Transportation. Two was catering, and three was security. So 1, 2, 3. Are you getting this? You know how to go, how to travel to your college. You don't need a school bus. Hello. All right. You know how where to eat. So you don't need food provided by college or institution. Yes or no?
Yes.
All right. And third was housekeeping and cleaning. So you people are grown up. You don't need that. Okay. So therefore it is not exempt. Please understand how they have written. Item contained in 1, 2, 3 of clause B shall apply to an education other than providing services by way of preschool and education up to higher secondary school. So they are saying exemption number 1, 2, 3 should not apply to any institution, should not apply to any institution other than preschool and HSC, other than preschool and HSC. So if this is preschool and this is HSC, so that point number 1 and point number 2 and point number 3 is applicable only here and not here. Hello?
Yes.
So transportation, catering and housekeeping. Please remember, transportation, catering and housekeeping is exempt only if you are providing to preschool or up to HSC. If you are providing to CA Institute, CS Institute, CMA Institute, Mumbai University, colleges, then it is taxable. I am taxable. Are you getting this? Because they are higher education bodies. Hello?
Yes,
am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Now next, point number, next exception. Further, nothing contained in sub item 5. 5 means online periodicals.
Yes.
Hello? Nothing contained in sub item 5. Okay, shall apply to institution providing services by way of preschool. So item number 5 is not applicable to preschool because that kid who is 3-year-old, if you give him iPad, he will take it and he will beat it. He will not use that as a PDF. They don't know how to use PDF. Yes or no? Alright. So preschool education and education up to HSC. So they are saying it is not applicable to them. Or education as a part of vocational educational course. So vocational training means singing, dancing. Alright. So for them, these online periodicals are not important. So what I am trying to say, 1, 2, 3 is applicable only here, not here. Yes or no? Then we are having point number 4. Point number 4 is applicable to all. Point number 4 is applicable to higher education as well as lower education. Hello? But point number 5 is applicable only to higher education. We have created that chart in your notebook. Can you go and check that chart? Hello? When you have written this particular thing, educational services, we have created that. Okay, 3 points are applicable only to preschool and HSC. First three points we have written, no? We have written something like this. Okay. See, we have written something like this. This 1, 2, 3 is applicable only to preschool plus HSC. Yes or no? This point number 4 is applicable to all. And this point number 5 is applicable only to after HSC, because it is not applicable to preschool and up to HSC. So we instead of remembering as a negative language, please try to remember as a positive language. Which exemption is applicable to whom? Okay. So first three exemptions are applicable only to preschool and up to HSC. Point number 4, conduct of examination is applicable to all institutions, and online periodical is applicable, this exemption is applicable only after HSC. This is easy language. Am I clear? Yeah? Can I go ahead? So this is how it is. Now there was an argument based on IIM, okay? For IIM there was so much arguments. Whether IIM is an education or not. What is IIM? Indian Institute of Management. What courses they provide? MBA. So MBA is a part of education or it's not a part of education? So this was the argument. Okay. Now MBA provided only by IIM is exempt. There are a lot of institutions in India who are providing MBA degree. Alright. You know that doesn't hold that much value also. Yes or no? Alright. Where I stay, Bhayandar, in that area itself, we are having 5 to 6 MBA college. Nobody knows about those college. Nobody recognize that degree. You pay 40-50,000 per annum and they will give you MBA degree in 2 years. Is it worth? Answer is no. MBA means, we recognize MBA means only from IIM. So if you are willing to do MBA or somebody in your family is willing to do MBA, then he must do only from IIM. Then only that MBA is MBA. Apart from that, it will be any private finance course. It will never hold value as if it is a MBA. So they said MBA only from IIM should be exempt. Already IIM fees are very high, 15 lakh, 18 lakh. Okay, if I put 18% on that, it will become more costlier to study MBA. Yes or no? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Alright, and therefore, they had exemption notification, entry 67, next entry to it. Okay. Entry number 66 was for education. The next entry was there for IIM. That entry is deleted. Exemption entry is deleted. This year it is deleted. The moment it got deleted from exemption notification, suddenly there was some myth. Okay. So many people had this understanding. Oh my God, I am deleted from exemption notification now. So it has become taxable. That's not the way. Okay. That has not happened. They deleted it by introducing IIM as a part of entry number 66. As a part of? They said two separate entries are not required because like CA Institute is also providing professional education. CMA Institute is also providing professional education. Similarly, IIM is also providing professional education. So they included IIM into educational institution and services provided by educational institution is already exempt under entry number 66. So you don't require separate entry for IIM. You don't require separate. Therefore, entry was deleted. The deletion was not with the intention to tax IIM. We are not taxing IIM. In fact, we have given them more value now. How? Earlier we had education institution separate and IIM separate. Hello. Now IIM are included in the education institution itself. Like Mumbai University, IIM, CA Institute, CM Institute, they all are same now. Hello. Okay. Yeah. So this is the one of the amendment I told you. Our CA Institute, no? Hello. I don't know what about CM Institute because I don't read much about your institute. Our CA Institute is having tie-up with IIM. Okay.
Yes.
And they are providing some management courses to us. Okay. Those courses are different types of courses. Sometimes it is 5-day course. Okay. Only 5-day. So 5-day they are going to take us to IIM Ahmedabad. We will stay there in 5-star hotel. Morning to evening there will be course. Okay. 5 days fees 1.5 lakh. Hello. This is how they are going to do conduct some 5 days course, management courses, some financial courses. So they have tie up with this IIM. Okay. 5 days, 10 days, then 1 month, then 3 months, this type of short duration courses. Is it a education? Say for example, I took admission to that finance course, which is provided by IIM to only chartered accountants for 5 days. Am I clear? Is it a education? You tell me, is it a education? No, it's not a education because they are not going to give me any degree. Are they going to give me any degree after 5 days? No, they are going to give me certificate of participation. What will that give me? They are not going to give me degree. Sir, you hold degree from IIM now. No, I don't hold any degree from IIM. I cannot write IIM degree holder. Hello. It's just that I entertained that course. I paid 1.5 lakh rupees plus GST. I have to pay GST on that. Am I clear? So if it is not a education, how will you know, how would you come to know about whether IIM is providing you education or participation? Hello. So if they are giving you degree, you understand, no, degree which is well recognized by law,
yes,
then they have provided you education, then it is not taxable, which are usually long term, 5-year MBA, 2-year MBA. Yes or no? All right so that is long term courses. They are not taxable in law. But if you are doing short-term courses where the degree will not be provided, only certificate of participation will be given, then it is taxable. Okay. So that point I wanted to tell you last time, and I ask you to leave place for writing that note on IIM. Okay. Can you see this amendment? Okay. IIM's. Okay. With effect from 31st January 2018, Indian Institute of Management Act came into force. So new act has been formed for IIM. Okay. This act is empowered IIM to grant degrees, diplomas and other academic distinction and titles. Yes or no? Hello? Specific certain process and admission to course program, study to academic content program. So this is how they are talking about IIM. Now IIM is a legal body, like CA Institute is a legal body, CMA Institute is a legal body, because we are from under certain act. Okay? Resultantly, all IIMs are now educational institution. All IIMs are now education institution, as they provide education as a part of curriculum for opting a qualification recognized by law. Okay? Now, what next, sir? IIM provide various long-term duration course program. Usually that program will be 1 year or more, for which they award a diploma or degree. This is the condition. If they provide diploma or degree duly recommended by Board of Governor as a power vested in them, IIM Act. Therefore, it is clarified that service provided by Indian Institute of Management to their student in all such long duration program are exempt. Okay? So now I have to write something like this. IIM, if they are providing diploma or degree, diploma or
degree,
then I have to write it as a exempt. Okay? IIM also provide various short-term programs. Various short-term program. So this is usually long-term. This is usually long-term. Okay. So here certificate of participation will be given. Certificate of? This is taxable. This is? Because this is short-term. Because this is? Short-term. So that we can read here. Usually less than 1 year. For which they award participation certificate to executives or professionals. To executives or? Professionals. As they are considered as a participant. They are not considered as a student. They are considered as a participant of the said program. This participant certificate are not any qualification recognized by law. Okay. Such participants are also not considered as a student of IIM. After attending 5 days course, I cannot say I was a student of IIM. I cannot say that. Services provided by IIM as an educational institution to such participant is not exempt from GST. Not exempt means it is
taxable.
And the rate will be 9% plus 9%. When CA Institute send that mail to us, we are conducting IIM course, 1,50,000. Or some fees they put, they also put plus 9% CGST, plus 9% HST, 18% GST is there. So you can, it can be clearly seen. Yes or no? Alright. Can you add this chart there? IIM two part. Okay, diploma and degree exempt, long term. We have left that place blank, no?
Yes.
Okay. If you want, you can put one more item here. Recognized by law. And here it is not recognized by law. Okay. Recognized by law and not recognized by law. Can you pause it? Video?